Today, I'm gonna show you how you can get this amazing Nagakiba katana. This is a secret katana that most of the player won't have very easy. Because if you want to take it in the proper way, you have to do certain things that I'm gonna explain in this video. First things first, this thing can do a lot of damage, and imagine the one that I'm using right now, it's only level 13. So we can make it level 24, 25. And it will be a monster of a sword. It's really big, it's one of the longest swords in this game, if not the longest katana that you can find. And again, everything that we are seeing right now, it's with only a level 13 sword. I'm gonna explain step by step of how you can get it. So, you know what? I think it's time for us to start. From the first step, you'll have to meet for the first time an NPC, a samurai. I'm just gonna fast teleport here to the Aegel Lake South. And this will be my first encounter with that samurai. Now, I'm gonna explain two different methods of how you can get this sword, but the first one, it will be a shame to try it, because yes, you can get the sword, but you will ruin this quest. And the method that I'm about to show is not hard at all. You can just kill this NPC and the sword, it will drop. But again, I will not advise you to do that. After you're gonna talk with him, your next path, it will be to be right over here on the map. This is on the right of the first step, and you'll have to defeat this NPC. The thing, I forgot the name. You'll get the finger Nejiri. Okay, I don't know how to pronounce that, but you're gonna get that knife. And if you just travel just further on the map from the Murkwater Cave, just here, you'll find the samurai again. This you'll have a conversation then. I told you this is gonna be an easy one, but you have to do certain things to get the sword in the proper way. Talk with him again right here under this bridge, or I don't even know, under these ruins. Nerijus invader. If you don't know how to get that invader, I already have a video on my channel. Maybe for you it's complicated. Then you have to make your way to the Liurnia Academy, and from this location you have to take the key from the island. On the left side, again, if you don't know how to get that key, I have a video on my channel exactly. It will guide you how you can get the key, but basically the key will be on an island on the left side behind the dragon. Take the key that you're gonna use on this gate, use it, enter, and probably most of you already been here. After you will enter in this academy, all you have to do is to get yourself invaded and fight another you'll have to start another fight, or you're gonna invade someone. Let's see. Take the Site of Grace and then just go on the right side to that bridge, that broken bridge. And from that broken bridge you can summon your samurai, Yura is the name. You'll see this red thing right over here. You can summon him. Yura is the name. And then a little battle will start. After you will defeat him, the next step it will be to go to the next and the last location in order to get the sword. You can leave all the hard work to the samurai, because it's gonna do a great amount of damage. You can help him with some spells, incantation if you like, but definitely after this invasion it will be over. You're gonna receive that rune arc, an item, and our step now is to go to the location where the katana will be. Easy as that. You can talk with Yura again. You want to get this awesome Ash of War, the Raptor of the Mists, one of the best ashes of war in this game in my opinion, in order to dodge attacks. Thanks for your help. Talk with him, and now let's go to the final location. The final location, you have to reach the Altus Plateau. Probably, again, most of you know how to be there. If not, I'm gonna explain very, very fast. You'll have to use the Dectus Medallion left and right. I have a video also with that medallion on my channel if you don't know how to get it. And then just reach the way to the Altus Highway Junction. We're gonna start from this location, because I just want to guide you to the second Church of Marika, where the samurai will be. And you're gonna find him injured. And then you can just grab the katana. Easy and nice. And if you want, I will advise you to do everything in this order. Don't just kill Yura and take the sword because you're gonna regret it later. You cannot complete the quest any longer if you do that anymore. So yeah, it will not be that good. Enter to the second church of Marika. Be sure of those dogs. Better if you for you to defeat those dogs before you enter, because they can attack while you are talking with Yura. So you can do that. Now talk with him. Take the sacred tear. And after a short discussion, you're gonna get the katana. I promise you that I'm gonna put every single katana that you can get on my channel. So yeah, this was a hard one to get, but definitely it's worth it. Do not stain the immaculacy of your sword. Now here you can grab it from him, the Naga Kiba, and then I'm gonna go to upgrade it. But unfortunately, I can make it only level 13, not level 24 or 25. Definitely in the future, when I'm gonna get more smithing stone, I will do that. Now, these are the stats. The piercing fang, it will be the skill that this sword has. I'm gonna show you the skill also in this video. And let's see what we can do with some enemies. This is just a little showcase. My build is not around dexterity. If you have a lot of dexterity, you'll be a god with this one. And I have to remind you, just make it level 24. You will not regret it. Just look at the level, at the damage on level 13. Don't mind my skills. I'm not the best samurai yet, but... Ooh, nice. Let's go to this giant. Okay, the first one was not a critical, but I'm gonna show what I can do with the skills of this katana. When I use this, oh nice, the critical damage is insane. Probably if it will be maxed out over 2 or 3k damage, and that was everything. Tell me in the comments if you like it or not. For me, it's just awesome. The fact that it's a really long sword, it can reach a lot of enemies. But also you can put an Ash of War on this thing, which it makes it even more interesting. Okay, those little buggers just jump on my neck. Always. I don't know how to dodge them. Scarlet Rat. Okay. And I have to tell you again, if you don't like the Ash of War that we're having right now, the Piercing Fang, the one that we got get by default, definitely you can ask, or you can change it to get a better new one. I don't know, whatever you like. Okay, I like to hit the air, but that, oh nice, the stabbing. Let's see what it can do to some dogs. Basically that's it. This is the weapon. I hope you enjoy it. Like, subscribe, share, press the notification bell. I'm gonna see you in the next one very, very fast. Be safe and see you soon. Bye.